Troy Galloway is a construction manager and consultant, commercial and residential builder, and a certified inspector for all commercial and residential buildings. And now, here is About the House with Troy Galloway.
Well, hello, folks. Welcome back to About the House. We're very excited. We got a great show here today. Oh, let me introduce myself. I'm Troy Galloway, owner of Galloway Building Services. And we are actually, as you've heard countless times over all the other shows, we are a construction consulting company. We do building inspections, commercial building, and residential. We also do expert witnessing for litigation work. Actually, we're one of the few companies out there in the whole country that do what we do. And so this is why we try to put these shows together. As you've watched several times over the last several years, our shows, that we try to bring folks in that are unique and that actually can help educate you in what you're doing. And that's why I brought these ladies in here today. And actually, I want to compliment Jeff Solomon for introducing us. Jeff actually has done our show with us. And folks, check it out. Jeff Solomon, he's a commercial architect. He did a great show with us. And so he introduced me to these ladies, which you really are going to love this show. But then these ladies was kind enough to introduce me to the next show, which we'll get into that later, because I don't want to steal any of the thunder from these two ladies here, because what they have here, I think that it's not only great for us baby boomers, but it's also great for so many of the other people in this country that are going through things right now. But I'm going to shut up and let them do their own spiel. Hello, Tiffany, Gretchen, introduce yourselves. Tell them. Gretchen, we'll start with you. I know one reason is because you're closer. You'll kick me in the shins faster than Gretchen can. So tell us a little bit about who you are, your background, and what brought you to what you're doing today. Not today. I know you brought. I talked you into it, but I mean, what's your company?
Yes. My name is Tiffany Dill. I am originally from Kentucky, so I'm a Southern gal, and moved to the Midwest with my husband. And when I actually got into this business originally, when we were building our house, or actually I should back up further than that, when we were looking for a home, our forever home, and we couldn't find it in the market because we wanted a bedroom, at least one bedroom on the main floor. And then we upgraded to at least two bedrooms on the main floor. So you definitely cannot find that anywhere. So we ended up building our own home. And when we did that, a lot of people mentioned to me something about interior design. And I thought, well, is that crazy to mix interior design with occupational therapy? Because that's what I have my degree in, but I also have a degree in master's in public health. So with that, I decided to form a company with a lot of encouragement and support from different people, and ran into another OT that also did the same thing that I thought was crazy to do and made it possible. So I ended up starting my company, and at the same time, I started the Inclusive Design Alliance in St. Louis, which is, I realized it wasn't going to take just me to make this change in this world to create more universal design homes and more inclusive spaces for people of all ages and across the lifespan, really, to live in, whether you have a disability or not. And we just ended up, let me back up. So I realized that it was going to take me. So I knew it was going to take a village. And so I started the Inclusive Design Alliance to have multiple professionals at the table to work together and try to make changes, whether it's in policy or education, just really empowering other people to think about using universal designs and accessibility in their plans.
Oh, okay. Now, you said OT. Now, I know you ladies, that's like, you know what that is. But tell folks what OT means, because I know you kind of went through that so, quickly, and they might not catch it, because it's important to understand the correlation between what you guys are doing. So what is OT again?
You can go.
Yeah, I'm Gretchen Kingma, and I too am an OT, which stands for occupational therapy. And occupational therapists help people after a major life event get back to doing what they want and need to do at home and in their community. So Tiffany and I both come from a healthcare background. It was about 6 years ago that I was going on maternity leave from a inpatient rehab facility where I was a full-time OT and managed 4 occupational therapy assistants. And I was just so frustrated that my role was to go home with patients before they would discharge back to the community. And I only had about 30 minutes to tell them all the things to change about their home so that they could safely stay there. And time again, those patients would come back. We'd call them repeat offenders because their homes weren't set up well for them. And so that's how I got into the housing space. I went on maternity leave. I told my manager, I'll see you in 12 weeks. Got home, told my husband, we have 12 weeks to figure something out. I am never going back there. And we have a real problem to solve. So I got licensed in real estate, became the OT realtor. And then we met, Tiffany and I met in similar spaces, her designing homes and helping people with their space, me helping people identify homes that they could age in place forever or easily modify their home. And we met through a mutual contact on social media, and our minds were blown when we asked the question, what part of the country are you in? And we ended up living 15 minutes down the road, and that's how Custom Joy came about.
Awesome. So how long have you been doing this now? Now as a company together, I know you've been doing it for a long time separately, but now that you've joined forces, how long have you been doing this?
I say we've been doing it individually and working together side by side for about 6 years, what she was saying, because we actually referred to one another before we even started Custom Joy. And we were like, wait a minute, we've got to do something about this. We need to form an end-to-end solution-based company. And so what we do is we offer everything from real estate to the construction and even consulting on cases. So, and that's how long we've been working together. So Custom Joy really just came about in April 2023, which was a few months ago. So
That's
been
great.
Really exciting. So we had a lot of clients that we share together, and we realized that we were kind of omitted at the table, and we wanted to be a part of the design process, the design build process with other contractors and clients. And because of that, we decided to start our own company so that we can work with our clients side by side throughout the process, but also empower other people at the table. So we don't want to feel like a competition. It's just more about working together. And we come from a profession where we work with other professionals. So it's called interprofessional collaboration. And we really value that. And so we want to carry that over. We want to educate and empower other contractors, other trades, and our clients about universal designs and accessibility. And so that's what we're doing with Custom Joy.
Well, I got 2 questions. The first one is omitted from the table. What's that mean?
Well, let me tell you what that means.
Yeah.
It means that we constantly would get clients who would come to us because of our expertise being marrying that healthcare with that housing piece. So we'll just use an example. Susie Q comes to either Tiffany or Gretchen, and Susie has a son who is a wheelchair user. And Susie really wants her house to be universally designed, which means that you're hiding accessibility in beautiful design. It doesn't look like a rehab hospital. So Susie comes to us and she says, we want a beautiful house, but we also want it to work for our son. We bring Susie to a contractor that we know, like, and trust and does great work. And then contractor takes Susie and son, and we no longer get to work with them using our healthcare background and knowledge. So that happened a handful of times where we were cut out of the client-centric process, and that's what we want to change.
And that is locally and nationally. So we work with clients nationally as well, virtually.
That's so... It's sad that that happens out there, but I'm sad, you know, I see this too in what I do, but which is kind of crazy because unless you're an expert like what you're doing, nobody's going to know what needs to be done. So you say about wheelchair people, but tell us some of the things that you do that I, as a builder, I don't, you know, I know some of the, I know ADA. I know how to do the inspections, which I do, but that is nothing. I mean, that's like kindergarten to what you ladies are doing. So tell us how what you're doing, why they need you along with them as a partner, not as a consultant would be also considered a partner, but a partner, because it's not just a matter of I tell you what to do. You got to also know what it is, what it looks like at the end, because you know what they have to work with. Mm-hmm. So some of the, tell us some of the things that you could help. Maybe, okay, let me start with this one. My adopted father, which I loved him greatly, was blind. Mm. And so he had issues, and there was nobody like you ladies there. We had nobody. He had me. Yeah. And, but what could you say? We'll use that as an example. Then we'll use that as a springboard to move on to others. But what could you do to help somebody that was blind and live in their home so that they wouldn't have to go to a nursing home?
Yeah, I think what we always like to say is we go beyond ADA. And so, and what we like to remind people, who, no matter who they are, whether they're the contractor, the client, or the trades that are working on site, but just letting them know that ADA does not apply to residential homes, and so it really just applies to commercial spaces, and even then, ADA has a lot of gaps. So just because ADA says something doesn't mean that it's accessible for every person, and so especially for someone that is blind, the ADA talks about things obstructing off the wall. So if you have a sconce on the wall, then you don't want it to stick out from the wall for so many inches because you don't want someone that is blind running into it. And then it has to be a certain height. And that is applicable. But then we think beyond that. We think about colors. We think about lighting. All of those things play a role in the design of the spaces. And so that's who we like to work with. We like to work with a team of people and put a dream team together for our clients so that we can make sure that their space optimizes their function so that they can live ultimately with more joy in their space.
Right. So with that, you know, we had you guys are doing this, and that's great. I never thought about the niche. I never thought, because we didn't have that. We were poor, you know. We didn't have niches sticking out. But that is really good to know, you know. And also, you know, there's so many things with that. But we live not only in a world of physical handicap, but we live in a world of a lot of mentally challenged people. God
bless hidden.
Them. What do you ladies, Gretchen, what are some of the things you could do to help them? Then we're going to go to seniors because I'm an old person. So before we get done, we're going to pick on old people. But for our mentally, the folks that have problems like that, how can we, what can we do to, because that's, you said lighting, so that would be one of them for sure. But
yeah, colors, paint selection, lighting, just space and how you utilize the space. So a regular contractor would, you know, maybe go to Pinterest and grab some ideas and throw to their client what is popular at the time for design trends. But marrying that healthcare piece, if somebody does struggle with any sort of mental health, we're going to interview them. We're going to ask what do they use the space for? So first and foremost, before we make recommendations, it's so important to understand what the goal is, how they utilize the space. We're not going to make a recommendation if they're not a sewer, we're not going to recommend a sewing table to be placed in the corner. So you want to know what's important to the client. And a lot of times just that space utilization is a huge one for mental health. Keeping a space decluttered, making the access easy. So getting around, it's easy, not cluttered, because our brain actually gets more stressed out. It doesn't process or make decisions when there's too much clutter. So just knowing what's important to them and then applying that to their space, that's how we work with mental health issues.
It almost sounds like we're in a metaphysical show.
Yeah.
You know, but it's really
well, it's
true.
All really evidence-based. So we really focus, we come from the healthcare background where we really focus on evidence-based practice. So we apply these evidence-based designs and spaces to what we're doing with our clients.
And so often we think of mental health as this stigmatized thing. I, as a mom of two toddlers and a very busy husband, am work full-time. When I get home at the end of the day, if my kitchen is a hot mess, I go into a spiral. And I'm a mean person and you don't want to be around me. And that is the same for our clients. And so we use not only lived experience, but like Tiffany said, just evidence-based data to inform our decisions.
You know, I'd love to tease you about that, about the clutter and how you get mean. But, you know, me too. Mm-hmm. And I'm amazed at just how, you know, we've always been taught this, you know, and it does make such a huge difference. But I often wondered how it would affect people that were, I mean, of course, handicapped, like blind. That makes logical sense. But I never thought about that. Never thought about that for people with mental issues that are working out there. Mm-hmm. And so I actually had a good friend, and she had her children were – Down syndrome children, and none of them lived, sadly, you know, but, you know, 20 years was the longest. But she had so many challenges that she had to literally improvise. There was nobody on the state level to help her. Do you folks work with anybody on the state level, or can you work in conjunction with some with that?
I'm going to brag on Tiffany here. The answer is yes, and it's also hard. The number one gap in the services that we offer is funding. Yet there are creative ways to fund these types of projects, and those look like state grants. Those look like long-term care insurance policies if you're a senior, insurance funds. And that is one thing that sets us apart from a regular contractor, is that we have heart and grit when it comes to getting our people funding. And we have a client who is a remote client in North Carolina, had a motor vehicle accident in the 90s, and he is now maybe in his 40s, and had a bucket of insurance money just sitting there, but it's allocated for home modifications. So he came to us to have Tiffany design a university design brand new construction. And he says to us, well, I don't think the funds can be used for my new construction because it states right here it's for home modifications. And Tiffany said, no, that's ridiculous. There's no reason we couldn't apply these funds to new construction. It's different, but it's helping you achieve what you want and need to do at home, like we went back to at the beginning, OT and occupational therapy. And so she fought for that and got the preliminary plans and the architect work funded through that bucket of money, because we were willing to just dig and find the answer for that client.
That is so awesome, because there isn't – we honestly, folks like myself, we don't know who to go to. Now we do. And yeah. After we get done promoting your company, there are going to be a lot of people. But I'm going to help you out, help remind me when we're out of here. I'm going to introduce you to the Shriners and the Children's Hospital, because I'm actually – involved in the Shrine.
Great.
And have
I
been.
Worked there.
Oh,
I worked there PRN, though, just like maybe once or twice a month.
We just presented to them.
Yeah, we just presented to them.
Oh, to get funding for projects?
No, not for funding, but we just presented like an in-service for them.
Okay.
Well, we'll so see just if to we talk can't, about what we
we'll,
do. And
we'll make some better context for you so you can
We are all about that, because like even there's pediatric funding, there's so much pediatric funding people don't know about. And like she said, we just get nosy and nerdy and we get down to the nitty gritty details, and we just love going on the hunt for this stuff. And then a lot of times people don't even know about the long-term care insurance and how that works. And so what we do and what we are able to do is, because we are healthcare professionals, we can write letters of medical necessity if it's needed, which most cases they are needed. So like the insurance company Gretchen was talking about for our clients in North Carolina, I had the architect, the builder, and myself, all three of us write letters of medical necessity to get that funding. And that insurance company said this is the first time they've ever covered new construction, which is super cool. But yeah, so we really get into the details of all of that and try to find some resources for them. And that's why it's end-to-end solution. We end it with walking away, providing our clients with the resources.
You know what really I think is so cool is that what you've said, and I think it cannot be emphasized enough. Not only are you making the home usable for the client, but you're also making it so it's beautiful, and it's not so when I sell my house, I think this is a great fear, you know, and I definitely as a builder know that this is a drawback when I build a building for senior citizens, because then it's designed with the cabinets up and, you know, and it's not pretty. You know, some of the things we have to do for seniors is not pretty, but you are making it where I could turn around and sell the house and everybody would love it, whether they got a handicapped child or not. That is so awesome. You know,
and Gretchen's really good about knowing, you know, what's going to help resell the house. And we always say that universal designs will increase the value of your home. It will not decrease the value in most cases. Yeah.
So now, are you contractors yourself, or are you the consultants with the contractors?
All of the above. Depending on the project, we are able to definitely play general contractor. We've done it before. The projects have turned out beautifully. And as a newer business, a lot of our contacts are coming to us from all across the United States, where we logistically can't be the general contractor. So we do both.
Good, good. Now, we've been mostly just talking about, so far, residential. Mm-hmm. But we have a commercial world still out there that, you know, from clients come, you know, that come in to visit the company to our employees. So help us out what you can help them make their life a little easier, not just our client, their clients, but their employees. What can you do? I mean, to help? I know ADA is ADA. Mm-hmm. Like you said, that's, you know, it's kind of like building codes. They're the least mm-hmm. requirement to get the job done, where you're actually trying to make it so we can use it.
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah.
What can you do to help out with that? Have you got into this much yet? Because there's a wide open market just for that.
It is. We do commercial as well, but it's more consulting based. So we work with the contractor on the job site. We work with the client. A lot of times I like to say that we are taking the stress and the load of stress off of our clients. So they're busy working in their practice. For instance, when I was working under my company, I was able to work with a pediatric dental office, which I'll have to say I got the referral from my husband. But I worked with them on their office from the beginning to the end. So we looked at the drawings and the plan. So I was able to consult on that and consult with the designers. They also had commercial designers involved. And so I worked side by side with the team of people. And as I mentioned, we work together as a team. So we're not like a one person or one, there's no I in the team. And so I liked working with everyone on that case. We also have potential projects in queue as we speak, that are commercial related projects. And so people come to us wanting a second set of eyes or a third set of eyes, whatever, whoever they need to have to help with reviewing, is it accessible for them? Or because it's not just about ADA. So when you're working in a commercial space, you want to think about who's using that space. You've got, if you're a dental practice, you've got your client, you've got your patient. You got the parents. I always think about parents that are bringing multiple kids in. They're bringing their pumpkin seeds. They're bringing in bags. You've got the postal delivery service guys. You've got the employees. You think about the employees that are coming in that office and how are you serving them and allowing them to be able to work for you and be comfortable. I actually had Maryville's Interior Design Program come and help out, and they ended up looking at the office for more accessibility, but also for ergonomic reasons. But also something that people don't think about in the commercial spaces are the emergency situations. So if you have an emergency, and this was an awakening for me when we had the state inspector come in for to do an inspection for the office. They have to inspect for like emergency escape route and that sort of thing. And they look at the corners, like, can you get a stretcher through the corners when you turn the corners, when you're getting out of a room, an exam room or something like that. So thankfully, I applied Universal Design and a lot of their process and setup that we had enough clearance to get out. There was one corner that was a little tight and I was not too happy about it because the door was a little narrow and I knew that, but I was just thankful that it made the clearance. But that's just something that I just realized, oh my goodness, I didn't even think about, you know, if somebody was coding or, you know, if something happened in the office and the emergency officials had to come in.
I never thought of that either. Mm.
And that happens in the homes too. So if you think about your homes, like how are the firefighters or how are the, you know, the EMTs going to get into your home and get out with you on a stretcher? Or if you're in the bathroom, think about the doors, the way the doors swing, you know, things like mm-hmm. that a lot of people don't think about. And like I said, we get to the nitty gritty details when it comes to that sort of thing. But I have to say every project that we've done, I have learned something and very thankful for that because it helps me with the, you know, future clients too.
I'm getting ready to do some consulting work with some folks that are building brand new Airbnbs. Actually, I'm meeting with them tomorrow and we're putting it together for them. I think that's a great idea, at least to have some thought mm-hmm. put into it. Why? Because naturally it's for safety. What a great advertising tool for them.
We have a statistic for you. Write it down, and you will be a champ tomorrow when you meet with them.
I'm writing. I got my pen and paper.
From our friends at Becoming Rentable, which is a platform that highlights accessible short-term rentals.
Becoming accessible. Say that again.
Becoming Rentable. They're an amazing company. Shout out to Lorraine Woodard. She is the CEO and founder of Becoming Rentable. We work with them a lot to promote this idea of the lack of accessibility in short-term rentals. But she shared a statistic with us last week that of the 1.3 million short-term rental properties listed in the United States, so that's Airbnb and VRBO, 0.002% of them are accessible. And isn't it fair to say that if you are ill, maybe, you know, the old Tim McGraw song, live like you are dying, if you are sick or aging or you have a child with a disability, who says you don't want to travel? Who says you don't want to go to the beach? So yeah, it's a very impactful statistic, but the work that they're doing at Becoming Rentable is to highlight that as well. So you should definitely bring that to your consulting job.
I will tomorrow. Mm-hmm. And they're great folks. And actually, I was involved in their inspections of their building or their home. Oh, I won't say anymore, but I won't say anything. Yeah. I won't say how on one of my YouTube videos about new home construction, you'll see literally where the builder missed the steel beam by 3 foot and the wood, the floor joists were just spanning and hanging in the air. Of course, they didn't know.
That sounds like my floor joist.
Oh, my. But you might not know this answer, but we've got 0.002, you said, percent. But is there a percentage of people that have mental and physical challenges? Do you know what that percentage is in America?
Yeah, over 26% of Americans live with a disability. However, that is self-report through the CDC. Mm-hmm. And who wants to acknowledge having a disability? That's not a sexy thing to sign up for. So our hypothesis is that everybody is going to have a disability at some point. When we had our kids, we were on short-term disability. If you have to have a C-section, you're on longer-term disability. So I think the correct answer for you is everybody at some point in time. The CDC would report that around 26% or 60 million Americans live with a disability.
Well, I know that one time that I said something about my wife's cooking, my eye was swelled for a few months. You know,
yeah.
I can see that disability.
It's just, there's so many things that people don't think about. And just to spin off of that, you know, you think about teenagers that, you know, have sporting accidents, or they're just having fun and they have an accident. They have to have surgery on their leg, or they have a broken foot.
Or 33-year-olds that play beer league softball and think they're 17.
Even adults.
Yeah.
Like,
just
it's just, you know, it's everyone. And if you think about, like, all of the homes that have bedrooms on the second floor, I've known so many people that have had to crawl up the steps to get to their bedrooms and their bathroom because they've had a temporary disability. It may not have been permanent, but that's how they get through it temporarily. And to me, it's like, oh my goodness, that's just wild. But then I also know someone I went to high school with back home. She recently passed away from cancer, but she ended up being in a wheelchair, and they built their dream home, and she was unable to get into their dream home when it was finished. And so to me, it just struck a chord even stronger. And I just felt like I felt even more passionate about what we did, because I'm thinking, this should not happen. You know, she should be able to get into her dream home. And so they ended up fundraising money for a lift to get her into the house. I'm sure they had a master bedroom or a primary bedroom on that main floor. But other than that, it's just saddening that, you know, they had to spend extra money, $20,000 extra, just to get a lift put into their dream home so she can access it before, you know, she passed away.
Yeah, it sounds like you really, there's a great need for that. You're right when you said one time or another. I'm thinking of myself, when did I ever have such a thing? Well, you know, I had knee surgery. It wasn't out very long, but you know, but then I'm thinking of my home. I have a beautiful home that I built on the Mississippi River on an island up there that my wife and I are talking about having to sell because we complained that the stairs are only getting taller. I know that's an old people joke, but it really, and so we're getting, so, you know, even though we're not necessarily you know, crippled or by any means, it does make a big difference.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I don't know what we could do about that. Actually, if I would have had some foresight, you know, into the future, I would have been able to think about it when I built it. And that's where you come in. Mm-hmm. But, you know, there wasn't anybody out there like you to even talk to. And there was no place to even go to. Which we're going to get to that at the end, so you can share people how they can find you.
Yeah,
well, Joey will help share this onto your webpage or to your Facebook or wherever you want it put out to. But yeah, because people don't even know you exist. Mm-hmm. You know, they're kind of like me. What I do, you know, when I do construction expert witnessing things, people don't even know that I exist. They, you know, and I know you're fighting the same uphill battle I am. You're developing such a new company type of system that there really isn't anybody you can copy to even imitate for your advertising. You know, you're having to do like me. You're inventing yourself all the way.
Yeah, and I think the other thing that I wanted to point out that sets us apart from other contractors or companies is not only our healthcare background, but we apply that for also people. We work with a lot of people that actually have neurological disorders. And so, and that means that their disease that they may have or whatever it is a progressive disorder. So meaning right now they're walking and they may be walking with a cane. But what people don't realize sometimes is the forethought that you were thinking about, this thinking ahead. I like to call it proactive designing, and meaning that we factor in their ability now, but we also factor in their ability down the road. And we also factor in any equipment that is going to be involved later on down the road. So, for instance, we have a client right now who is in a manual wheelchair. And when he had his bathroom redone 15 years ago, he was walking and standing. And because he has multiple sclerosis, it has progressed. And so my brother-in-law also has multiple sclerosis, and he was going through the same situation where they needed to make some changes into their home or modifications. And so we redid the bathroom for our client. Who is now in a manual wheelchair, but I also measured him for his power wheelchair, which he has, but he doesn't have to use it right now, but he will eventually probably have to use that power wheelchair. So the turn radius is going to be a lot larger than a manual wheelchair.
Oh.
So a lot of times people may not think about the size of the equipment, and then the equipment change over time. So now the power wheelchairs stand, so they don't have to have the lower countertops. So when we redo their kitchen and we just redid the bathroom, we don't have to lower the countertop. He can still roll underneath it, but the power wheelchair will help him stand so they don't have to have a super low countertop.
I'm going to put it in layman's terms.
Yeah.
And it sounds funny, but in order to work with us well, we always tell our clients, you're hiring us to be the friend that tells you that you look fat in your dress, that you look bad in that outfit.
Only a girl could get away with that.
Yeah, that's true.
That'll be my other eye will be swelled now.
And it's because of those things. We have sat at the table from a healthcare perspective as occupational therapists and had the hard conversations. And we know that these home modifications, these home renovations are a huge investment. And so we'd hate for you to have to sink an additional 20, 30K in just 5 to 10 years because somebody didn't give you the cold, hard truth. So that is part of working with us. And you have to be okay with hearing that.
Yeah, you have to. And I think most people would if you present it like that.
Yeah.
Because that is a tough one, especially for us guys. We hate the idea that we're not the man we used to be, which kind of leads me to my next area about veterans. And a lot of the veterans out there, they're desperately in need of help and existing homes and of maybe a new home. So I know they have all the problems everybody else has, but like the wheelchair is what made me think about it. But I don't know how we could get you into the veterans area because I think that they just, they need you. And I don't know how, I don't even know what kind of funding's out there for veterans anymore. I'm a veteran, so got to bear with me. I'm a Marine Corps veteran.
Well, we thank you for your service, and you'll be happy to know that their home modification funding through the VA is still very strong. The bathroom that Tiffany was just mentioning, that client is a veteran, and so the bathroom was fully funded by a VA grant, and that's super exciting when we are able to work with a third party like the VA because they really care for for the veterans, and it gives us extra sense of purpose when we're able to give back to clients in that way.
That is awesome, because you just said something I think needs to be said again. And I sound like you said that you've helped them get a grant. Mm-hmm. So you know where we can where they can find the monies. You know where they can get some help at from the different organizations. Is that right? Don't let me put words in your mouth.
For the most part. And if we don't, we're going to find out. Mm-hmm. So if we don't know where to get the money from, we're going to come hell or high water, find the money. And that's what we were talking about when Tiffany said we like to be nerdy and nosy. We're just going to keep asking questions to benefit our clients until we get the right answer.
Now, we had a good show on here with Berkshire. Is that right? Sure. Okay. So thank you. And they've been on a couple of times. And the last show they had on, we talked a lot about different things for seniors, mm-hmm. like alerts and things like that. They could probably, and I think I maybe even, I did introduce you to Matt Walt. But if he don't get back to you quick enough, you let me know. I'll introduce you straight to the boss.
Yeah.
Not his wife. That's the other boss.
Yeah.
The one that actually writes the check. But that's a great way, because there's just so much out there that, people, like my mother-in-law, I remember she fell and broke because she tripped. She tripped going to the bathroom in the middle of the night and broke her hip and then died a month later.
That's a statistic too. That's where most of the falls happen on the way to the bathroom, especially at night.
I could see that as being an older person.
And it's also the amount
of
turns that you have to make. Like if you have a straight shot to the bathroom, your risk lower.
Oh, there you go. Mm-hmm. Just something simple like that.
Yeah. And it's our duty, our fiduciary to our clients to not just go after the big renovation project. And I think that's another thing that sets us apart is we have tiered level of services. So just this week, we had a lead come to us. Mom and dad can't figure out their TV at night. We live in De Pere. Mom and dad live in South County. We're driving 30 minutes a night to go turn off the TV. We want to meet with you about building a multi-generational addition onto our house. And my first response is, that's a $100,000 project. Have you tried the smart technology? Have you tried the Alexa TV where your dad could just learn, Alexa, turn the TV off and save you the trip every night? And she was so grateful that I brought up very low cost options to keep mom and dad at home safe. And at the same time, mentioned that they'd been thinking about it for a while. So it might delay their big, huge expense of doing an addition. But if we're not giving our clients those options, then what good are we doing out in the world? And so there are a ton of low-hanging fruit, we like to call them, that will maybe be a Band-Aid for some, but it might solve the problem for others.
Yeah, that's great. I would like to straight to the bathroom. I never thought of that. Mm-hmm. And,
or automatic lights.
Yeah.
Just getting a motion sensor light off Amazon. Change out your switch. Have a handyman do it for $25 an hour. Mm-hmm. Yep. And then you're not on the hook for remembering to turn your light on.
$25 an hour handyman. I need his name.
Yeah, they don't exist.
They don't.
Task Rabbit.
I got some friends that are going to be listening to the show. They're a handyman company. And we actually had someone on the show, and they're going to say, ooh, $25 an hour. That's what I have to pay my labor.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. And I want to add, too, to the funding sources. Our client that was a veteran, there's another veteran grant that he also utilized. It's called the PVA, Paralyzed Veterans of America. And so he got a grant through them as well to help fund. So whatever the veteran or the VA was unable to cover, then the PVA picked up some of the funding for his bathroom project.
That's awesome. We need we need all the help we can get. And that's why I liked about this show is that we can bring in to like you folks and educate the people. Because honestly, I bet you 99% of the people until they hear this show, they don't even know people like you exist.
Right.
And I don't know how to get the word out any faster than what we are right now. So anyway, tell folks, because we're going to wrap the show up here, because I know you got another show coming right up. You guys are so popular. tell us how we can find you make contact with you, not just, through email or phone or however best fits your format, because I know there's going to be a lot of people out wanting just to ask questions, and you're good to answer questions. I can see you're passionate. You love what you do. And that is, that right there is what makes you winners, is your passion and your caring for the others. And I could just see that that's you're doing this more for helping others than helping yourself. And I think that's all, I think it's a beautiful thing. So share with yourself, share with the folks.
Yeah. Our website is www.customjoystl.com. And you can email us at Tiffany, just like it sounds, T-I-F-F-A-N-Y, at customjoystl.com, or hello@customjoystl.com.
Oh, so they can't reach you?
Our phone numbers are on the website, but me personally, I'm hello.
Oh, you're the hello. Oh.
Gretchen's too long. I don't know what my parents were thinking.
Well, that's a good German name, and we love it.
Yeah. Well, we and we're a sister company of Empowered Homes, which is her real estate side of it. So we have the real estate side and the construction side. So Custom Joy basically is the sister company to Empowered Homes to make that the end-to-end solution.
Well, we only got just a short period, but we really going to have you come back here in a few months and such. Mm-hmm. And I would love to, I'm going to see if I could pick your brain and maybe you could come on and do some blogging with me. You know, we can promote your company that way, because I just see such a huge need in it. And people just need to know you're there.
Yeah.
And we're going to do everything we can to help get that out there, because you're not just St. Louis, which we're broadcasting out of St. Louis today, but you guys are throughout the whole country.
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah, we've had
makes
clients
it awesome
in
so
several,
everybody
from
can
Iowa
hear.
To North Carolina to New York City.
Yep. Mm-hmm. We've had them all over the place. I like to say that we have a burning passion, and it's hard to simmer that.
Yeah.
So it's on fire. We cannot simmer it, and we will not stop.
Well, that's awesome. That's a beautiful thing that you're doing to help the folks. And I know that it is greatly appreciated by everybody. Well, folks, thank you for listening to our show. This is Troy Galloway. Hey, you can find us. You ever have any construction issues or problems or concerns, give us a call. People, honestly, we don't charge anything for answering and ask a question. I get people all the time, call all over. Actually, it used to be just America, but I just had a phone call from Canada a couple weeks ago about some commercial issues. So give us a call. Touch base with me. You have any questions. If you're getting in a lawsuit, give us a call. Sadly, whatever side you're on, sometimes you just have to have a non-biased opinion. So give me a call. Troy Galloway, Galloway Building Services. And our phone number is 314-520-6655. And you can find our webpage, which actually will be at the bottom of our YouTube videos, but it is www.gallowaybuildingservices.com. And there's a whole bunch of information out there, and we're going to have their show even on there. So you can if you don't find us one place, you'll find them another. All righty. Well, thank you, ladies. I greatly appreciate your time. God bless you all. Thank you for listening.
Sponsored by Troy Galloway and Galloway Building Services, GallowayBuildingServices.com.